This video explains how to complete the writing section of the English exam. Remember, start with the writing section first. It's worth a huge 36 marks. You'll be marked for how well you write in a particular style, how well you use a variety of punctuation marks and capital letters, how you organise your work, and your spelling skills. So how to begin? At the very start of the exam, read through the reading text that you've been given in the exam and make sure you understand the sort of thing that they want you to write about. The texts usually have a theme, such as recycling or fitness. So read through to get an idea about what the theme is of this year's exam paper. Now begin with the last question in the booklet. This is a longer question and is worth 24 marks. So the biggest reading questions are worth 16 marks and 12 marks. So this writing question, this last one in the book, is worth beginning with because you can attack it while you're fresh in the exam, get 24 marks, which is a really big amount of marks to collect on your first question, and you can really do well in the first part of the exam. So you should spend 30 minutes on this question. You have four sides of paper to fill. Higher students have slightly more. But aim for no less than 2.5 to 3 sides of writing for a C grade. Any more and it tends to be going on too much, any less is just too short, so 2.5 to 3 sides. Underline keywords in the question and brainstorm the features you should include. So sample planning, I completed this in about 3 minutes. I took the question from last year's exam, write the text for a leaflet to persuade students to help make your school or college more environmentally friendly. Straight away I underlined the keywords. Now leaflet, I wanted to know what sort of thing was I've got to write. Persuade, I know now that I'm going to have to try and persuade people. And being more environmentally friendly, that's the thing that I'm trying to do, that's what I'm trying to achieve through my writing. So I listed reasons to be environmentally friendly, first of all, and just thought of one idea per paragraph. So paragraph one will be about increased global warming. I can throw in some statistics there, some facts, making those statistics up. Number two, too much waste in school. Number three, it's fun to recycle. Number four, we owe it to future generations, and so on. And ending with number six, how they can start recycling and being more environmentally friendly today. So that's a nice, powerful concluding paragraph. I've then added persuasive devices, and I know DeForest is writing to persuade, so I'll remember what DeForest means, and we'll go through that in a moment. And I've also put down some key features, key higher punctuation marks, so semicolon, exclamation mark, dash, ellipsis, to remind me to use those in my writing. And then I've listed some connectives that I could use as well, just to remind me how to use connectives at the start of paragraphs and when in my writing too. So that planning didn't take me very long at all, but it is important to plan because it does help you to remember the features that you've got to put in those essays to get a C grade, and it also helps organise your work, and we are marked for the organisation of our writing. So the shorter question is just like the longer question, only you've got less space to fill and you've got less time. So you've got 25 minutes on this question. There's nothing to tell you that you've got this amount of time, so you've got to check the clock and make sure you stick to timings, or else you're going to run over and then you won't be able to get marks on the other questions in the reading section because you spent too long on this part. So it is very, very important to check the timings, keep looking at the clock. So you've got two sides to write, don't do any less. Higher people, you will have more room to write, but two sides of writing, or just a little bit more, is just about the right amount. So you should concentrate on your punctuation, style, paragraphing and spelling. Plan an answer very quickly in the way I've just shown you. Now I'm just going to quickly go through the features of some writing styles. So writing to persuade. Pause the video here and try to remember the features of DeForest. Direct address, such as you should do this. An anecdote is a short story, a little story about something that proves your point. So if you were appealing for the RSPCA, telling a story about a dog, Billy, who'd been rescued outside their town, city centre store and then nursed to health and found an adoptive home, that would be an anecdote to support your point. Alliteration, could be Big Bad Billy. They're words that all start with the same noise or sound for emphasis. Facts. So using facts to support your point. And if you don't know them, make them up. Opinions. Rhetorical questions. Really easy to use. So how would you like it if your dog was left to starve? So making the audience think about what you're trying to say. And repetition, so words or phrases repeated for effect. So the dog was left to starve, the dog was left on the streets, the dog was left in agony. So you're repeating the point for effect. Emotive language, such as death, tragedy, evil, words that are really strong and try to create an emotion in the reader. Statistics, you can make these up. So 1 in 3 Staffordshire Bull Terriers are rejected by their owners. So make them up if you don't know them. And triplets, again, just repeating, but 3 times. Now, writing to argue is very similar to persuade. And you should use the forest, but you must present both sides of the argument. A good way to do this is to use connectives. So one paragraph would be saying, perhaps about why you should donate money to the RSPCA using DeForest. The next paragraph, though, might say about why people believe that they should be giving money to children's charities instead. Then another paragraph about why it's good to donate to the RSPCA. But then another paragraph arguing, again, perhaps in addition, research has found that money given to children's charity has more impact than those given to animal charities. So use your connectives to bounce ideas off, but you're going from one side of the argument to the next side of the argument, back to the first side of the argument using DeForest. Writing to describe. Now use colour, similes, metaphors. Personification, so where you're giving an object a human quality, such as the candle danced in the moonlight or the trees waved their branches, to make it sound like they're doing something as a person. Strong words for effect. LY words, such as quickly, slowly, and focusing on small details, such as a bird in the sky, and write a whole paragraph about that, just zooming in on small features. And don't forget as well to use chunky paragraphs. We don't want to see small ones. We want to see 3 sentences on the same topic. So if you're describing that bird in the sky, we'd like to see 3 sentences about it before you move on to describing something else. So a revision task that you could complete, spend 15 minutes describing your street in summer, then spend another 15 minutes describing it in winter. Writing to inform. Some sample questions. Write a leaflet that informs students of the dangers of smoking. Write an article that informs students of the importance of recycling. So if we're going to do the first one, that informs students of the dangers of smoking, we'd want to include some facts about why smoking is dangerous, some commands telling them that smoking shouldn't be undertaken, it's very bad for the health, so don't do it. Direct address, you should stop smoking now. In order to stop smoking, you should do this. Connectives, such as firstly, lastly, etc. And statistics. Writing to advise. Now, in school, we've done a video about the bear attack. So that's one question you could think of about how you would encourage students not to, how to avoid a bear attack. But you could also, the questions that might be included are advise students on the benefit of exercise. Advise young people how they could recycle. Advise the governors how they could lessen incidents of bullying in school. So we want some facts about why it's good to exercise. Some connectives. Furthermore, it's good to exercise because. In addition, it will benefit your health because. You should exercise because it could benefit your health by. So using those modal verbs of would, should or could. Rhetorical questions, so how would you like to be healthy and fit? Statistics, so 1 in 3 teenagers are overweight. Again, make them up if you don't know them. Take the tone of an expert and make it sound that you are the expert, you know what you're talking about. Give the reader hints and tips, so the top 5 hints on how to get fitter over the next week. Opinions presented as facts, for example, no one likes a bully. And direct address, like you could do this, making the reader feel like you're talking directly to them. So how to get the higher marks? As a bare minimum, make sure that you use capital letters, full stops and paragraphs. Check this at the end of your work. You should use commas, semicolons, exclamation marks and ellipsis for a higher grade. Think of the VCOT pyramid when you're looking at your work to make sure that you've used as many as the wide variety of punctuation marks as possible. Write chunky paragraphs. We don't want very slim, little teeny tiny paragraphs. We want nice chunky ones, so 2 to 3 sentences per paragraph. And begin with a powerful opening and end with a powerful ending. Very important. So don't just drift off at the end of the piece of writing. If it's a letter, make sure you sign off saying, I hope to hear from you soon. Or if it's a writing to advise, make sure that you say how that person can do what you advise today. So here's a revision task. So you could do that for 60 minutes, 35 minutes for the longer task, 25 minutes for the shorter task. At the end of that task, or to think about at the end of your piece of writing in the exam, this is what you should do. Check for punctuation. If you've missed any punctuation marks, add some. Don't be scared of not adding punctuation marks. It's better to try rather than not to bother at all. So make sure you've got capital letters as well. Check for paragraphs, and if you've forgotten to do it, then add a // if you forgot them. Check for vocab, cross out words and make them better if they're not strong enough, and make sure you have a powerful ending. So here's a quick recap quiz. Pause the video here to read through the recap quiz questions and see how many you've got right. Okay, going to the answers now. When should you start the writing question? Well, right at the start of the exam. So first of all, read through the reading texts, then go right to the back of the booklet and start the last question first. Then go to the next question in the writing section. How much time should you spend in the writing section in total? Well, 1 hour is the total for those two writing questions. So the longer writing question is worth 24 marks, and you should spend 35 minutes on that longer question. How much time should you spend on the shorter question? 25 minutes, because it's worth 12 marks. So that's a total of 1 hour, 35 minutes on the longer question, 25 minutes on the shorter question, and your responsibility is to keep an eye on the clock and make sure that you don't run over those times. What 4 elements of writing will you be marked for? Well, style, punctuation, paragraphing, and spelling. And by style, I mean writing in the correct style of writing to persuade or writing to inform. And name 3 C+ level punctuation marks, semicolon, which just means there's more information to come about a statement I've just said. So if I enjoy exams, semicolon, I think they're great fun. So that last statement adds to the first statement. The dash works in exactly the same way. And the ellipsis is a pause in time, so it makes the reader pause for a moment.